In this video, we will talk about equipment validation in pharmaceutical industry and discuss what is design qualification, installation qualification, operational qualification, and performance qualification. Hi guys, welcome to my channel with another video. In this video, we will discuss about equipment validation in pharmaceutical industry and see what are the steps in its validation process. We will discuss what is equipment validation, who performs the validation, and what is the process or essential steps in performing validation. So let's start. Validation is defined as a documented evidence which provides high degree of assurance that a specific process will constantly produce a product meeting its predetermined specifications and quality attributes. It means to provide evidence that the result of a product or process will be according to the specifications and requirements agreed before the buying process. Each process and stage of validation must be documented. Without documentation, validation results are not acceptable and is not considered complete. Validation is carried out for both a process and equipment in a pharma facility. It is necessary to validate both equipment and its process. Process validation means validating a pharma process against the agreed specifications and to provide evidence that the process is capable of delivering the required results. Example of processes are sterilization and filling. Equipment validation means to verify the effectiveness of pharma equipment according to the agreed specification during buying process. Example of equipment are blister packing machine and tablet compression machine. Equipment validation validates various parts, components, and accessories against the specifications agreed upon. It also ensures that its working and operation does not deviate the required specifications. If the validation outcome meets the agreed standard specifications, equipment is said to be validated. Production is only allowed for a validated equipment. Otherwise, production is not allowed until equipment is validated. There are various departments in a pharma facility that are directly related to operation of a pharma equipment. So who performs the validation? Either it is engineering, quality, or production. Validation is performed by a team comprising of personnel from all the relevant departments. The relevant departments are production, quality, and engineering. Validating equipment is not only related to quality, engineering, or production department. Instead, all three departments are included, which have their own roles and responsibilities. Quality department is responsible for executing the validation activity. Other departments are responsible for providing necessary support to quality department. Quality department is responsible for activities such as planning, executing, documentation, and resource allocation. The quality department coordinates with all the relevant departments to smoothly execute the validation activity. Production department. A representative of an area where the equipment is installed must be present during validation activity. The production personnel is responsible for providing production-wise facilities such as arranging equipment, product, or packaging material. Engineering department. Engineering department is responsible for providing engineering support. He or she is also responsible for analyzing the machine's performance and take action in case of fault occurs. Now let's discuss what is the process of validation for equipment in a pharma industry. There are four stages of validation. The purpose of each stage is to make sure that the entire life cycle of pharma equipment has been validated, from design conception to its installation, to its operation, and finally to its output. The four stages are design qualification, installation qualification, operational qualification, and performance qualification. Let's look at each stage and see how they are executed in a real pharmaceutical environment. Design qualification. Design qualification is the approval phase of equipment specification or the requirements of the buyer. In this stage, the specifications of equipment are checked whether these are according to the buyer's requirement or not. The design qualification is prepared by the manufacturer and is sent to the buyer. The equipment buyer verifies it according to its needs and requirement. And the buyer also approves it or not approves it. When DQ is approved by the buyer, the manufacturer then starts the manufacturing equipment. Otherwise, the manufacturer is bound to include all the specifications in design qualification phase. The next stage after the design qualification is the installation qualification. In this stage, equipment installation is verified and checked to see whether the installation is carried out according to the equipment's and manufacturer requirements. Additionally, it is also checked that the supplied equipment contains all the requirements such as documentation, material of construction, accessories, and components. Some common tests in installation qualification includes documentation. In this test, it is checked and verified that the manufacturer has supplied all the documentation that was agreed upon during the design qualification stage. Example of documents include operational manual, maintenance manual, wiring diagram, and preventive maintenance schedule. Calibration certificates. Certificates of calibration for all measuring devices, whether analog or digital, must be provided. Example include temperature, pressure, and airflow. Calibration certificates must be valid and not expired. Accessories. The supplied equipment must contain all the accessories that were agreed upon during the design phase. Operational qualification. It is the verification of equipment's operation against the specifications agreed upon during the design phase. It is written evidence that the equipment functions according to the agreed requirements. Some common tests in operational qualification include basic machine operation. It includes tests that are related to basic machine operation, such as machine start, machine stop, and all the functions from the control panel. Safety systems. It includes tests related to safety systems, such as verification of emergency button, machine guards, door lock, and door safety sensors. Equipment output capacity. It includes verification that the actual output or speed of the equipment is according to the agreed specifications. Motion control. If motion control is employed in the equipment, such as for file adjustment, they are verified against the agreed specifications. Temperature control system. If equipment consists of temperature control system, such as in blister packing machine, or in autoclaves, its temperature control feature is checked and verified. For example, whether temperature cuts off at its required set point, the deviation in temperature is in acceptable range, and the overall performance of temperature control system is satisfactory. Instrumentation. In this test, operation of all instruments is verified and checked. It is verified that all instruments are in working condition, are powered up, outputting correct value, and its display is also okay. Example of instrumentation include temperature, pressure, airflow, and level. Performance qualification. Performance qualification is the final stage of equipment validation, and validation is concluded in this stage. In this stage, equipment is validated as a function of its product rather than verifying individual function. The equipment is operated with its functionalities with actual product and packaging material if required. The output product is also tested for verification of the desired properties. Thank you for watching. I hope you really enjoyed this video. Please subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon so that you immediately know when there is a new video. You can also read this article on PharmaSpec's website. Link is also in the description.